أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد, we are going to start today inshallah with Surah Al-Jasiyah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حاميم. تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز الحكيم. إن في السماوات والأرض لآيات للمؤمنين وفي خلقكم وما يبث من دابة آيات لقوم يوقنون. صدق الله العظيم. We have seen that most of the surahs of the Quran are in the form of pairs. This relationship has been very evident regarding these last four surahs of the Hameem series. We have seen the Surah Al-Zukhruf and Surah Al-Dukhan. Both started Hameem wal Kitab al-Mubin, both of them. Now the next pair, Surah Al-Jasiyah and Surah Al-Ahqaf, both starting Hameem Tanzeelul Kitab min Allahil Aziz al-Hakim. Also we find that most of these surahs begin with the mention of Quran. Now Hameem Tanzeelul Kitab min Allahil Aziz al-Hakim, sending down of this book is from Allah, who is all-powerful, all-wise. إِنَّ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ Verily, in the heavens and the earth there are signs for those people who believe. وَفِي خَلْقِكُمْ وَمَا يَبُثُّ مِنْ دَابَّةٍ آيَاتٌ لِقَوْمٍ يُوقِنُونَ And also in your creation and that which He has spread, the moving creatures, there are signs for those people who are convinced. وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ In the same way, in the alternation of the night and the day. وَمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مِن رِزْقٍ And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down from the heaven, from sustenance. فَأَحْيَا بِهِ الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا And then He revives the earth or land after its death. وَتَصْرِيفِ الرِّيَاحِ And in the changing of the direction of the winds. آيَاتٌ لِقَوْمٍ يَعْقِلُونَ In all these things there are signs for a people who understand. تِلْكَ آيَاتُ اللَّهِ نَتْلُوهَا عَلَيْكَ بِالْحَقِّ And these are the revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which we are reciting unto you with truth, with a purpose. فَبِأَيِّ حَدِيثٍ بَعْدَ اللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ يُؤْمِنُونَ Then in what discourse after Allah and His revelations will they believe? If they are rejecting the ayat of Allah, now what will they believe? وَلُّ لِكُلِّ أَفَّاكِ نَسِيمٍ Woe to every sinful liar. يَسْمَعُ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِ He listens to the revelations of Allah recited to him. ثُمَّ يُسِرُّ مُسْتَكْبِرًا Then he persists and insists in arrogance. كَالَّمْ يَسْمَعَهَا He behaves as if he had not heard them. فَبَشِّرْهُ بِعَذَابِ النَّلِيمِ So give him a glad tiding of a very painful chastisement. وَإِذَا عَلِمَ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا شَيْئًا اتَّخَذَهَا هُزُوًا And when he comes to know from our revelation something, he takes them in mockery. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُّهِينٌ For them, there is the chastisement which is humiliating and degrading. مِن وَرَائِهِمْ جَهَنَّمْ Behind them is the hell. وَلَا يُغْنِي عَنْهُمْ مَا كَسَبُوا شَيْئًا whatever they have earned during this life of theirs, it will be of no avail to them. وَلَا مَتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ. And also, the gods, false gods and protectors, they have taken unto themselves, besides Allah, they will also be of no avail. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. And for them will be a mighty chastisement. هَذَا هُدًى. This is the guidance. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ. As for those who reject and disbelieve in the revelations of their Lord, لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مِنْ رِجْزٍ أَلِيمٌ. For them shall be a painful chastisement of wrath. اللَّهُ الَّذِي سَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْبَحْرَ. Allah is He who has subjected the sea to you. لِتَجْرِيَ الْفُلْكُ فِيهِ بِأَمْرِهِ. So that the ships may sail through it by His command. وَلِتَبْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. And so that you can seek out of His bounty. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Or so that you become thankful to Allah. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. This ayah is very noteworthy. The emphasis, jamia. And He has subjected to you everything that is in the heavens and everything which is in the earth. All of them. This ayah clearly tells you, the position of man as vicegerent of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only those things which are in this world and this earth and round about it, they have been subjected to man. Whole universe has been subjected. So now, when we are conquering this space, this is actually in line with the Quran has said. Allah had already subjected this whole universe to us. It's only the time which has elapsed, just as a seed has to take some time to become a plant. In the same way, this progeny of Adam had to take some time to get all that knowledge that it has gathered. And we can't say up to what more limits this human knowledge is to go. Actually, this has to go to the level of Dajjal. When all the forces of nature would be subjected to Dajjal, he will have conquered all the forces of the nature. And that is why he will then claim, I am God. When I have conquered whole of the universe, then I am God. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا جَمِيعًا مِنْهُ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Verily, in this are the signs for those people who reflect and ponder. قُلْ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَغْفِرُوا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ أَيَّامَ اللَّهِ. O Prophet, say to those people who have come to believe, your followers, يَغْفِرُوا. They should forgive for some while, for a while, those people who don't hope and don't expect the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now this Ayyamullah, we have been mentioning it many a times. In the terminology of Quran, the days in which the big command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was executed, destroying whole nations. وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. Tazkir bi Alaillah and Tazkir bi Ayyamillah. I mentioned these two terms adopted by Shah Waliullah Dehlvi, rahmatullahi alayh. So because they don't fear it, so give them some respite. Let them ponder, let them think. Don't wish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bring them the chastisement immediately. قُلْ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَغْفِرُوا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ أَيَّامَ اللَّهِ. لِيَجْزِيَ قَوْمًا بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fully rewards the people of what they do. You give them time so that they can show what amount of evil they have within them. Let the whole evil come out. مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلِنَفْسِهِ. Whosoever does good deeds, he does it for his own sake. وَمَنْ أَسَافَ عَلَيْهَا. And if he commits some evil, well, it is against himself. ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ. And then to your Lord you will be returned. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحُكْمَ وَالنُّبُوَّةَ. And we had given the children of Israel the book and the judgment and prophethood. And hukum can means kingdom also. The book, the kingdom and the prophethood. وَرَزَقْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ. And we provided them with good things. وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. This is for the fourth time in Quran about Bani Israel. And we raised them higher than all the nations of the world. Actually in Quran, Alameen, literally should mean all the worlds. But this is a style of Quran that taking the plural something, but what is meant is the thing that is in that. So plural denotes to that. Alameen, all the nations of the world, all the peoples of the world. فَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. Twice in Surah Al-Baqarah, once last night, and now here again for the fourth time. وَآتَيْنَاهُمْ بَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ. And we gave them clear proofs of the command, the ten commandments that Allah gave them. فَمَقْتَلَفُوا إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاهُمُ الْعِلْمُ بَغْيًا بَيْنَهُمْ. Afterwards, they didn't differ. But after the knowledge had come to them, and the reason was their jealousy, mutual jealousy, mutual, you know, hatred, you may call, the urge to dominate over each other. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ يَغْزِي بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Verily, your Lord will judge between them on the day of the judgment, on the day of resurrection. فِيمَا كَانُوا فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ. In all those matters in which they had been differing. ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاكَ عَلَى شَرِيَةِ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ. And then, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have established you on a sharia of our command. Now it's very important to note, the sharia is after Moses to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hazrat Masih alayhi wa sallam didn't bring any sharia. It was hikmah, as we have read last night. Hikmah, wisdom. The essence of iman and faith. But the sharia was the same. And he said so. His words are still preserved in the gospel. Don't think I have come to destroy law. This law of Moses will remain. But now Quran has come. And this is the new sharia. ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاكَ عَلَىٰ شَرِيَةٍ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ. Then we have established you on the sharia of our command. فَاتَّبِعْهَا. So you have to follow that. وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. And don't follow the caprices or the wishes or the lusts of those people who don't know. إِنَّهُمْ لَنْ يَغْنُوا عَنْكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْءٍ. They will not be able to save you from Allah. Not at all. وَإِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ. These evildoers, they are friends to each other. Some of them are friends to each other. Allahu waliyul muttaqin. As for the God-fearing, the friend and the protector is Allah. Hadha basairu linnas. These are enlightenments for the people. Wa hudan. And guidance. Wa rahmatul liqawmin yuqinun. And mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the people who are convinced. أَمْ حَسِبَ الَّذِينَ اجْتَرَحُوا السَّيِّئَاتِ أَنْ نَجْعَلَهُمْ كَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَوَاءً مَحْيَاهُمْ وَمَمَاتُهُمْ. Do these people who are committing and doing evil deeds, they think that we shall make them and those people who have come to believe and who are doing good deeds equal? How is it possible? You have disbelieved, they are believing. You are doing bad deeds, they are doing good deeds. How can they be equal? Sawaa mahyahu wa mamatu. Will their living and dying be equal? Saa ma yahkumun. Very wrong is the judgment or the opinion that they have formed. Wa khalaqa Allahu samawati wal ardha bil haqq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the heaven and the earth with truth. That is means with the purpose. There's nothing purposeless over here. وَلِتُجْزَى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ. And so that every soul is recompensed whatever it has earned. وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. And they will not be wronged. No injustice will be done to them. Now comes one of the most important ayat of Quran regarding shirk, the practical aspect of shirk. أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَٰهَهُ هَوَاهُ. Have you seen or considered the case of a person who has taken his own nafs? That means the lusts and desires of the nafs, of the id and libido, as a god for himself. He is saying with his tongue, La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah, repeating and repeating and repeating. While actually, he has made his desires, his lusts, god. Why? He is obeying them without seeing whether it is halal or haram. It is permissible or prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A desire emerges from your id or libido, from amongst your animal instincts, and you follow the desire, you fulfill it. All gratification of that desire you do without seeing whether the way you have adopted is permissible according to the Sharia of Allah or prohibited. So now who is your Lord? Your God is your nafs. Now nobody has ever bowed towards his nafs or prostrated before the nafs. But this is the practical shirk. I might think, and I might be proud, I'm 100% muwahid. Because as far as the tawheed in creed is concerned, tawheed fil aqeedah, well, I am satisfied that I have fully understood it and I take it. But what about this practical side? Taisa abdu dinare wa abdu dirham. Woe to the servant of dinar and dirham, bondsman of dirham or dinar. His name is Abdul Rahman. Actually, he is Abdul Dinar. When he is after getting dinar, without seeing whether it is halal for him or haram. The love of dinar, the love of dirham, the love of money and wealth is more in their hearts than the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who is their Lord? Who is their God? Practically, wealth. They are worshipping wealth, worshipping dollars, worshipping pounds, worshipping notes, rupees, and takas, etc., etc. أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَٰهَهُ هَوَاهُ وَأَضَلَّهُ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has led him astray despite all his knowledge. He is a PhD, PhD in tafsir. He got a PhD from McGill in hadith, in fiqh, but he is the bondsman of his wishes. You might be an alim, you might be a mufassir, you might be a muhaddis, you might be a faqih, you might be a mufti, but if you are serving your lusts and desires, irrespective of whether something is permissible or prohibited, then you are mushrik in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَخَتَمَ عَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِ وَقَلْبِهِ وَجَعَلَ عَلَىٰ بَصْرِهِ غِشَاوَةً. And of such a person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put a seal on his heart and on his hearing, and there is a curtain before his eyes. فَمَنْ يَهْدِيهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ اللَّهِ. Now who can give him the guidance after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has, so to say, put a seal on his heart? أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. So are they not admonished or reminded? وَقَالُوا مَا هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نَمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا. And they say, there is no other life for us except this life of this world. نَاهِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا. نَمُوتُ We die ourselves. وَنَحْيَا And live ourselves. Now, يُحْيِي and يُمِيت means Allah gives life. Allah puts you to death. They said, no. We die ourselves. We live ourselves. This is the materialism of this age. There's nobody. This is the world of matter. There are laws of physical change, laws of chemical change. Under these laws, this universe is going. There's no need of some controller and somebody running this universe. No. We don't believe. وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهْرِ And nothing kills us except the time. Time passes and we are finished. That's all. No God. This is dahriyat. You might have heard this word. Dahriyat. Materialism. Dahriyat. وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهْرِ وَمَا لَهُمْ بِذَلِكَ مِنْ عِلْمٍ They don't have any knowledge of it. إِنْهُمْ لَا يَذُنُّونَ They are only conjecturing. Guessing. وَإِذَا تُطْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا بَيِّنَاتٍ And whenever clear revelations are recited unto them, مَا كَانَ حُجَّتُهُمْ Their last argument is, إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا بِآبَائِنَا إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ In the long run, in the end, they always used to say, okay, if there is going to be resurrection, bring our forefathers before us. Then we shall believe that there can be resurrection. قُلِ اللَّهُ يُحْيِيكُمْ Say, Allah will revive you. ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ Allah is keeping you alive, يُحْيِيكُمْ ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ Then He will put you to death. ثُمَّ يَجْمَعُكُمْ إِلَىٰ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ Then He will gather you all together to the day of resurrection, in which there is no doubt. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ But most of the people know not. وَلِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ And for Allah is the sovereignty and kingdom of the heavens and the earth. وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةِ And the day on which the hour will come. يَوْمَ إِذِنْ يَخْسَرُ الْمُبْتِلُونَ On that day, the followers of falsehood will be the losers. وَتَرَى كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَاسِيَةً كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَاسِيَةً You will see all the nations. They will be kneeling down. كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ تُدْعَى إِلَىٰ كِتَابِهَا Every ummah, every group, every nation will be called towards the book of the record of its events and deeds. And then, الْيَوْمَ تُجْزَوْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ And then it will be said, today you will be rewarded and recompensed for what you had been doing. هَذَا كِتَابُنَا This record of ours, this book of ours, يَنْتَقُوا عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْحَقُ It is speaking against you with truth. There is nothing wrong in this record. As I said, it might be a computer, a big joint computer. Simply, you press a button and the life of a person, of an individual, the whole film might start. Now, how can you deny? You are doing it. See it. Is it not you? How will you deny? هَذَا كِتَابُنَا يَنْتَقُوا عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْحَقُ إِنَّا كُنَّا نَسْتَنْسِخُ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ We had been writing and recording what you were doing. فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ Now, so, those who came to believe and they did good deeds, فَيُدْخِلُهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ فِي رَحْمَتِهِ So their Lord will admit them, make them enter His mercy. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَضْلُ الْمُبِينُ And that will be definitely the most manifest success. وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَفَلَمْ تَكُنْ آيَاتِ تُتْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ As for those who disbelieved, it will be said to them, Was not my revelation recited to you? فَاسْتَكْبَرْتُمْ But do you show arrogance? لَكُنْتُمْ قَوْمًا مُجْرِمِينَ And verily you are the guilty people, criminals. وَإِذَا قِيلَ إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ وَالسَّاعَةُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا And when it was said that the promise of Allah is true and that hour will come, there is no doubt about it. قُلْتُمْ مَا نَدْرِي مَ السَّاعَةُ You said, we don't know, we can't understand. What is this hour? In nazunnu illa zannan. This ayah, as I understand it, is, we can say that the condition of most of us is reflected in this ayah. You think, yes, your arguments are convincing. It seems that a day of judgment should come. The virtuous people should get their reward. It's very logical. And the culprits and those people who were rebellious towards their Lord, they must be punished. Yes. But in nazunnu illa zannan, we do feel what you are saying is correct. It might happen. But وَمَا كُنَحْنُ بِمُسْتَيْقِنِينَ. But we are not convinced. And unless the conviction is there, there will be no change in your behavior. A dogma, believing in the day after the last day and resurrection, but not the conviction. So you will spend everything to get this world. Unless there is a conviction that that day has to come and there is going to be the life of hereafter and that will be the eternal and that will be the real life. Unless this conviction is there, your attitudes, your behavior in this world will not change. وَإِذَا قِيلَ إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ وَالسَّاعَةُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا قُلْتُمْ مَا نَدْرِي مَا السَّاعَةُ إِنْ نَظُنُّ إِلَّا ظَنًّا وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمُسْتَيْقِنِينَ. We do feel it might happen, yes, but we are not convinced. وَبَدَا لَهُمْ سَيِّئَاتُ مَا عَمِلُوا. And then the evils that they had committed will come before them. وَحَاقَ بِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. And then those things will encompass them about which they were be mocking. They were mocking. What is Jannah? What is Jahannam? They were laughing at it. But now those things will come before them as realities. وَقِيلَ الْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاكُمْ كَمَا نَسِيتُمْ لِقَاءِ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا. It will be said to them, today we shall forget you. Just as you forgot the meeting of the day, of this day of today. You just ignored it, so we are going to ignore you. Go away. وَمَا وَاكُمْ مِنْ نَارِ. And your abode is fire. وَمَا لَكُمْ مِنْ نَاصِرِينَ. And there are no helpers for you. ذَلِكُمْ بِأَنَّكُمْ اتَّخَذْتُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ هُزُوًا. This is because you took the revelations of Allah in mockery. وَغَرَّتْكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. And the life of that world, previous world, it deceived you, deluded you. فَالْيَوْمَ لَا يُخْرَجُونَ مِنْهَا. So today you will not be taken out of this hell. وَلَا هُمْ يُسْتَعْتَبُونَ. Nor they will be given any leave to appeal. Okay, apologize. When you give this permission to somebody, what does it mean? If you apologize, I'll forgive you. But no. There this door will be closed. No leave of appeal or apology. فَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ رَبِّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَرَبِّ الْأَرْضِ. So, for Allah is the all praise, who is the Lord of the heavens and the Lord of the earth, رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, who is the Lord of all the worlds. وَلَهُ الْكِبْرِيَاءُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And to Him belong the dominion and majesty of the heavens and the earth. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. And He is all-powerful, all-wise. Now the last surah of this series of Hameem, Surah Al-Ahqaf. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hameem. تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز الحكيم. The same. The sending down of this book is from Allah, who is all authority, all powerful, and all wise. ما خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما إلا بالحق. We have not created the heavens and the earth and whatever is in between them, but with truth and for a fixed period of time. this universe will not go on and go on forever. No. This used to be the idea, maybe about half a century back, the era of Newtonian physics, Newtonian physics. The idea was that matter has been here from ever, it will remain forever. The law of indestructibility of matter. Matter cannot be destroyed. So this world, this universe cannot come to an end. This was the idea prevalent among the physicists. But now the things have changed. Now, on the one hand, they say this universe is expanding, the theory of expanding universe. And then a time will come when it will fold on itself and it will come to an end. Started from one point and it will go to the same one point again. So, ajalin musamma, this is not an eternal creation. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا عَمَّا أُنذِرُوا مُعْرِضُونَ. As for those who have disbelieved, they are turning away from what they are being warned. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. Say to them, see, consider, whom you are calling upon besides Allah, أَرُونِ مَعْجَا خَلَقُوا مِنَ الْأَرْضِ. Please show me, what have they created in the land, in the earth? أَمْ لَهُمْ شِرْكُوا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ. Or do they have any partnership in the heavens? إِتُونِي بِكِتَابِ مِنْ قَبْلِ هَذَا. Bring to me any book which might have been sent down before this book that I am presenting. أَوْ أَسَارَةٍ مِنْ عِلْمٍ. If not a book, any remnants of knowledge. إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you are truthful. وَمَنْ أَظَلُّ مِمَّنْ يَدْعُو مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مَنْ لَا يَسْتَجِيبُ لَهُ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Who is more farther astray than the person who is calling upon whom, calling upon him besides Allah, who is not going to answer him till the day of resurrection. وَهُمْ عَنْ دُعَائِهِمْ غَافِلُونَ. And they are unawares that somebody is calling upon them. The angels, they don't know that some people are there in Arabia praying to us, calling to us. Maybe the souls and spirits of the saints, they might be absolutely unaware that someone is saying, Ya Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani Shayin Lillah, Oh Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani, give me something. They would be unawares. وَهُمْ عَنْ دُعَائِهِمْ غَافِلُونَ. وَإِذَا خُشِرَ النَّاسُ قَالُوا لَهُمْ عَدَانَ. And when the mankind will be gathered, they will become enemies for them. وَكَانُوا بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ كَافِرِينَ. And they will deny having been worshipped. وَإِذَا تُطْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا بَيِّنَاتٍ. And when our clear and shining revelations are recited unto them, قَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِلْحَقِّ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ. هَذَا سِحْرٌ مُبِينٌ. Those people who disbelieve, who have rejected, they say about this truth which has come to them, this is clear sorcery and magic. أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَاهُ. Do they say that Muhammad has forged it, composed it himself, صلى الله عليه وسلم. قُلِنْ افْتَرَيْتُهُ فَلَا تَمْلِكُونَ لِي مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْعَ. Say, if I have forged it, then you don't have any authority to save me from Allah's wrath. This is the biggest crime in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَا تَمْلِكُونَ لِي مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْعَ. You won't be able to help me against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هُوَ عَالَمُ بِمَا تُفِيدُونَ فِيهِ. He very well knows what you say among yourselves concerning it. When you are alone, you say, no, this what Muhammad is presenting, well, it seems to be beyond human power. They say, no, 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 where are you going? It seems, you know, his magic has come over you. So, but these in their private meetings, they used to admit, this is of other source. This is not the composition of Muhammad himself. Kafa bihi shahidan baini wa bainakum. Allah is sufficient as a witness between you and me. Wa huwa al-ghafurur rahim. And he is the forgiving, the merciful. Qul ma kuntu bid'a min ar-rusul. Say, I am not the first messenger, that no messenger had come before me. Bid'ah, and bid'ah means something absolutely new. In our Sharia, if some new rite or ritual is invented without having any proof in the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sunnah of the Sahaba, then we call it bid'ah, because it has no roots. So, ma kuntu bid'ah min ar-rusul. The case is not that I am the first messenger of Allah, and nobody had before me claimed to be messenger of Allah. وَمَا عَظِيمَا يُفَعْلُوا بِهِ. This ayah, whenever I read and pass by it, I shiver. What is Muhammad saying, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and what he is being commanded here to say? وَمَا عَظِيمَا يُفَعْلُوا بِهِ وَلَا بِكُمْ. I don't know what will be done to me and to you. This is extreme humility before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My matter is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever He will decide. Allahumma inni abduka wa abnu abdika wa abnu amatika fi qabzatika nadil fiya hukmuka adlul fiya qadauka. Oh Allah, I am your bondsman. My father was also a slave of yours. My mother was also a slave of yours. And I am in your grip. Fi qabzatika. Nasiyati biyadik. My forehead is in your hand. Mazil fiya hukmuk. Within my body, within myself, your command. Your command is effective. Adlun fiya qazao. Whatever you command and decide for me, it will be justice. This is abdiya, the climax of abdiyat. A man reduces himself to nearly zero. I have nothing, O Allah. Everything is with you. You know everything, I know nothing. فَإِنَّكَ تَعْلَمُ وَلَا عَلَمُ وَتَقْدَرُ وَلَا أَقْدَرُ. This is a part of that very important dua of istikhara, about which the companions of the Prophet say that the Prophet taught us this prayer, just like he taught us Quran. Allahumma inni astakhiruka bi ilmika wa astakhdiruka bi qudratika wa asaluka bil fadlika al-azim fa innaka taqdiru wa la aqdiru wa ta'lamu wa la alamu. You have all the authority, I have no authority. You know everything, I don't know anything. This is humility, humbleness before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ مَا كُنْتُ بِدْعَ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ وَمَا أَدْرِي مَا يُفَعْلُ بِي وَلَا بِكُمْ إِنَ اتَّبِعُ إِلَّا مَا يُحَى إِلَيَّ. Only I am following what is being revealed to me. That's all. وَمَا أَنَا إِلَّا نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. And I am only a warner, plain and clear warner. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ وَكَفَرْتُمْ بِهِ وَشَهِدَ شَاهِدٌ مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَلَى مِثْلِهِ. Say to them, just consider, if this Quran which I am presenting is really from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you have rejected it. On the other hand, a witness from among the children of Israel, he has testified that this is correct. Now this ayah, about the interpretation of this ayah, there are many opinions. One is that it's common. All the people who accepted Quran from among the Bani Israel, Yahud, so this ayah denotes to them. One opinion is especially Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He was a very knowledgeable person among the learned people of Jews. And some say this denotes to the prophecies made by Hazrat Musa and Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Wallahu alam. Fa'amana wastakbartum. So he confirmed, and you are showing arrogance. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَعْدِ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Verily Allah doesn't love such evildoers. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَوْ كَانَ خَيْرًا مَا سَبَقُونَ إِلَيْهِ. And so said those who disbelieved regarding those who came to believe. They were common people, poor people, some of the slaves, some of whom you call handymen, just as Khabbab al-Arat, he was a blacksmith, and so on and so forth. Now the chiefs of the clans of Quraysh, they said, had this thing been a precious thing, these people would not have come forward, accepted them. We should have come forward first and accepted it. Because Allah is generous to us. He has given us wealth. He has given us position, honor, power. So how come that these menials, ma'azallah, how could they come forward? They could not have superseded us. And they who disbelieve, say of those who believe, if this message were a good thing, they would have not attained it before us. وَإِذْ لَمْ يَحْتَدُوا بِهِ. And when they have not accepted its guidance, فَسَيَقُولُونَ هَذَا إِفْكٌ قَدِيمٌ. So now they will say, this is an old falsehood. وَمِنْ قَبْلِهِ كِتَابَ مُوسَى إِمَامًا وَرَحْمَةً. Before this Quran, there was the book of Moses, alayhi salatu wasalam. That was the guide and mercy, إِمَامًا وَرَحْمَةً. These words appear in our dua, our prayers regarding when we say to Allah, Allahumma rabbana anis fahshatana fi quburina warhamna bil Quran al-azim waj'alhu lana imaman wa nuran wa hudan wa rahmah. Make this Quran leader for us so that we follow it. Imaman wa rahmah wa hadha kitabun musaddiqun lisanan arabiyan. And this is the book which has come confirming Torah in Arabic language, لَيُنْذِرَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. So that these people who have gone astray, they should be warned. وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُحْسَنِينَ. And so that there should be glad tidings for those who achieve excellence in their deen of Islam and Iman. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ. Who are those? Muhsaneen. There is those who said, our Lord is Allah, and then they stuck to it. They stood firm in it. Firm regarding aqidah and creed. Firm regarding practice and deeds. Really obeying him. And not obeying anyone else. In which there comes a disobedience for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not loving anything, anyone more than Allah. This is istiqamah. To say, Rabbulallah is easy. But to show firmness on it is not an easy job. Allama Iqbal says in Persian, to me goyam musalmanam billarzam. When I say I am a Muslim, I tremble. Why? Kadanam mushkilati la ilaha. I know what are the difficulties of this la ilaha illallah. Saying this word, these words is very easy. But to fulfill them in your practice and action is not an easy job. So I tremble. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. For them there will be no fear and no grief. أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ. They will be the dwellers of the garden. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. And they will stay there forever, forever. جَزَامْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And it should be the recompense or reward for what they had been doing. وَوَسَّنَ الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ. And we have enjoined upon man kindness towards his parents. This we have read in Surah Luqman also. But here, إِحْسَانَ, this word has come clearly. Kindness and good behavior. And respect and service to the parents. حَمَلَتُ أُمُّهُ كُرْهًا وَوَضَعَتْهُ كُرْهًا. His mother kept bearing him in his womb with hardship, and then delivered him with hardship. وَفِصَالُهُ ثَلَاثُونَ شَهْرًا وَحَمْلُهُ وَفِصَالُهُ. And this period of the bearing and the weaning of him is 30 months. حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَ شُدَّهُ. Until when he reaches his maturity, وَبَلَغَ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً, and reaches the age of 40. This place is very important. Quran says, the maturity of human beings is at the age of 40. What type of maturity is it? Physical maturity, 16, 17, 18, you are mature fully. But this is the psychological maturity. The psychological maturity of a person, it is at 40 years. Hatta iza balagha ashuddahu, until when he reaches his maturity, and now it has been explained, وَبَلَغَ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً. That is, he attained the age of 40. قَالَ رَبِّ أَوْزِعْنِي. Now he says, O my Lord, grant me أَنْ أَشْكُرَ نِعْمَتَكَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيَّ وَعَلَى وَالِدَيَّ, so that I can give thanks to you for all the blessings that you bestowed upon me and my parents. وَأَنْ أَعْمِلَ صَالِحًا أَعْمَلَ صَالِحًا, and grant me that I should do good deeds, righteous deeds, تَرْضَاهُ, which you like, with which you are pleased. وَأَصْلِحْ لِي فِي ذُرِّيَّتِي, and also make my progeny good for me, if my progeny is also righteous. Their deeds will add to, you know, my reward in the hereafter. أَصْلِحْ لِي فِي ذُرِّيَّتِي إِنِّي تُبْتُ إِلَيْكَ, I turn my face towards you, وَإِنِّي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and definitely I am from among those who have surrendered themselves before your will. This is very important. Before this age of 40, let me say that nature uses man. Man comes to himself at the age of 40. Nature is using us. Nature wants that there should be procreation, this generation after generation. This world is to continue. It has to be inhabited. So you do it, run away, run this way, that way, get married, now you have children. Now just bring them up. So nature is using you. Until this age, passions, emotions, sentiments, in most of the peoples, they get the upper hand. But at the age of 40, you know, these things somewhat settle down. And then the man thinks, who I am, where I am heading. And at this stage, if he is still a tool in the hands of his id or libido, then he is doomed. But at this age, if he delivers himself from the overpowering of the id or libido, comes to himself, he takes up to himself an ideal, an asmal ayn, I have to live for this, die for this. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So he is a person blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ نَتَقَبَّلُ عَنْهُمْ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا. They are those from whom we shall accept the best deeds that they would have been committing. وَنَتَجَاوَزُ عَنْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ, and we shall just overlook their evils. There can be no human being absolutely free from any bad deed. There is a hadith of the Prophet, كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمَ خَطَّعُونَ وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّعِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. All children of Adam, they commit mistakes. But the best among these people who commit mistakes are those who repent, come back, refresh their covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ask his forgiveness. They are the best people. So now Allah says, we shall just ignore. Maybe they have committed something wrong also. But if the general direction of the life, general direction is correct, you have turned your face actually to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. You are proceeding in that direction. But during this journey, maybe at some time you slip, you fall. Okay, no harm. Stand up. Continue the journey. So these pitfalls might be there. But the direction has to be correct. And if your direction is correct, maybe you have not been able to achieve much. No harm. If you kept on in that direction and you kept on spending whatever you had for that purpose, well, you are successful in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Despite the pitfalls, despite any shortcomings, despite any evil deeds which might have happened, وَنَتَجَاوَذُ عَنْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ فِي أَصْحَابِ الْجَنَّةِ, and we join them, make them enter and go with the dwellers of the garden. وَعَدَ الصِّدْقِ الَّذِي كَانُوا يُعَدُونَ. This is the true promise which was made with them. Now this is one character, that when he is mature psychologically, he says, رَبِّ أَوْزِعْنِي أَنَشْكُرَ نِعْمَتَكَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيَّ. He has come to know his creator, his Lord, and is praying to him. But there is another character also. وَالَّذِي قَالَ لِوَالِدَيْهِ. On the contrary, the one who says to his parents, أُفِّلْ لَكُمَا, fie to both of you, أَتَعِدَانِنِي أَنْ أُخْرَجَ, you say that I will be taken out again from my grave. وَقَدْ خَلَتِ الْقُرُونَ مِنْ قَبْلِ, so many generations have passed before me. وَهُمَا يَسْتَغِيثَانِ اللَّهَ وَيْلَكَ آمِنْ, and the parents, father and mother, they are imploring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and saying to him, woe to thee, believe that you will be resurrected. Don't go in the opposite direction. إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ, verily, the promise of Allah is true. فَيَقُولُ, then he says, مَا هَذَا إِلَّا أَسَاتِرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. No. Mother and father, you keep these things with you. I am not going to believe in these things. I think these are the fables of the ancients and nothing else. So both characters you will find in the world. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ حَقَّ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقَوْلُ فِي أُمَمٍ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ. Those are they against whom has been proved true the word of chastisement among the communities of the jinn and mankind that have passed away before them. So many people going. He is also one of them. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا خَاسِرِينَ. Verily, they were the losers. وَلِكُلِّنْ دَرَجَاتُمْ مِمَّا عَمِلُوا. And for all, there are ranks according to their deeds. All people of the garden are not equal. There are levels. In the same way, in the hell, they are not equally treated. Different types of chastisements for different types of people. وَلَيُوَفِّيَهُمْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ وَهُمْ لَا يُسْلَمُونَ. So that Allah pays them back in full their deeds, and they are not wronged. وَيَوْمَ يُعْرَضُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا عَلَى النَّارِ. And the day, we call the day, when those people who are disbelieving, they will be presented before the fire. This is, come and see with your eyes. أَذْهَبْتُمْ طَيِّبَاتِكُمْ فِي حَيَاتِكُمُ الدُّنْيَا. And it will be said, you received all good things in your life of that world, which is now gone. You enjoyed. You rejoiced. You had plenty. You had the luxuries. You have tasted all good things in that world. وَاسْتَمْتَعْتُمْ بِهَا. And you have enjoyed their comfort. فاليوم تجزون عذاب الهون بما كنتم تستكبرون في الارض بغير الحق وبما كنتم تفسقون. But today, this day, you will be given the reward, the chastisement of humiliation and degradation due to the arrogance that you were showing in the earth, في الارض بغير الحق, without any right. وبما كنتم تفسقون, and because of your transgressing. واذكر اخا عاد, just make a mention of the brother of the nation of عاد, that is حضرت هود عليه الصلاة والسلام. After the people of Nuh were destroyed, that was the first nation which came up from the sons of Sam alayhi salatu wasalam. Semitic races. The first was who went down directly to the south and settled in the southern area of the Arabian Peninsula, which is now called Ahqaf. Ahqaf means the mountains of sand. It's a very, very, very severe type of desert. But at that time, it was very fertile. Now, when the azab of Allah came, chastisement after that, it is now the worst, worst ever desert in the world. Waskur akha Aad. Now just mention, make mention of the brother of Aad, that is Hud alayhi salam. Is under a qawmahu bil ahqaf. When he warned his people in the sand hills, وَقَدْ خَلَتِ النُّذُرُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ, and other warners had passed before him also. Also, you know, Nabi and Rasul, many Anbiya can come, but finally the messenger comes, the Rasul comes, and then the fate is decided. أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهِ, all of them had been saying them, don't worship and obey anyone except Allah. إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم عظيم. Verily, I fear for you the chastisement of a mighty day. قالوا جئتنا لتعفقنا عن آلهتنا. They said, have you come to us and you want to turn us away from our gods? فاتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من الصادقين. If you are truthful, now bring to us the chastisement which you are threatening us with. Bring it. قَالَ إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. He said, knowledge is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When your term comes to an end, he knows. When the judgment will be issued by Allah, he knows. I don't know. وَأُبَلِّغُكُمْ مَا أُرْسِلْتُ بِهِ. I am only conveying to you the message with which I have been sent. ولكني أراكم قوما تجهلون, but verily I see, O my people, that you are ignorant people. You are not seeing what could happen. فلما رآه عارضا مستقبل أوديتهم, and when they saw a sudden cloud advancing towards their valleys, قالوا, they were happy. قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا, this is a cloud, it will give us rain. بَلْ هُوَ مَسْتَعْجَلْتُمْ بِهِ. No, 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 it is not the rain. It's that chastisement about which you wanted to hasten. You wanted rain. Okay, that has come. رِيْهُنْ فِيهَا عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. A very strong and harsh wind in which there was a painful chastisement. تُدَمِّرُ كُلَّ شَيْنٌ. Destroying everything بِأَمْرِ رَبِّهَا. Due to the Lord, due to the command of their Lord. فَأَصْبَحُوا لَا يُرَى إِلَّا مَسَاكِنُهُمْ. Now they became that nothing was seen, nothing was visible except their dwellings. People who dwell there, they were not to be seen. Finished. كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْقَوْمُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. In this way, we reward the people who are guilty. وَلَقَدْ مَكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي مَا إِن مَكَّنَّاكُمْ فِيهِ. And O Quraysh, we established them in this land more than we have established you. Whatever we gave to Aad, we have not given to you. وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ سَمْعًا وَأَبْصَارًا وَأَفْئِدَةً. And for them also, we give them the hearing and seeing and inferring from أَغْنَى عَنْهُمْ سَمْعُهُمْ وَلَا أَبْصَارُهُمْ وَلَا أَفْئِدَتُهُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. Nothing of these faculties could avail them anything. إِذْ كَانُوا يَجْحَدُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ. When they were rejecting the revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَحَاقَ بِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. And the things about which they were mocking, they came and they encircled him. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.